Previously on Ugly Betty.
Connor ran off with all the money.
As of noon today, all of the Mead accounts have been totally cleared out.
We clean up our own mess. I'm gonna start liquidating my personal assets, everything I've got.
I'll contribute as much as I can.
Which fabulous fashion world editor has begun to sell off her clothes willy-nilly?
I have a son now, and it's his company, too.
I have to be careful of sometimes. Remind myself that I am not his mother.
But bus, really, Daniel? This is the lowest moment of my life.
For God's sake, hold on to the pole.
Wait, I don't know who touched that thing.
My family is sort of really wealthy.
I just feel like I don't know that much about you.
Well, here's something else you might not know. I'm kind of really into you.
Decided the limo treatment doesn't suck.
Noted. Also, for the record, I'm not really a limo kind of guy. I just thought it might be fun since it's, you know, Tuesday.
Tuesday. Now officially known as Limo Day. Seriously, Matt, stop pampering me. It makes me feel filthy.
Damn. There goes Hot Air Balloon Wednesday. Sounds good, doesn't it? Seriously, I can make that happen.
I know. I believe you. But it all feels like a little much, you know, with the cutbacks at work. And...
I know. But for you, Hot Air Balloon Wednesday, Submarine Thursday, as long as it makes you happy, just name it, anything.
Well, I don't think you can make me any more happy. But I'm going to go out on a limb and say that things at work are going to get better.
Really?
Yeah. Sort of my grand unified theory of happiness. With us so good, how could work be bad?
Excuse me, sorry, just trying to get out.
Hey, watch it! Excuse me.
Hey, that's right!
Mode Magazine, please hold.
Mode Magazine, hold. No, he's not available. Please hold.
Amanda.
Hey! You cannot just take that. That is Mode property.
Breathe, Mandy, breathe.
Guys, what is going on?
We're being looted. I feel so violated, and not in a good way.
Didn't you hear? The sex issue was a limp noodle, and now they cut the budget to the bone. Oh, God, this is so depressing. I just used the word noodle and bone, and I got nothing.
Apparently, everything leased or considered non-essential has to go.
I'm looking for Betty Suarez.
Do you need any help loading her onto the truck?
You need my ID for a delivery?
It's protocol. Sign here. And here.
Is this all really necessary?
Initial here. And I need your thumbprint.
My thumbprint.
Identity confirmed.
Whoa.
The Calvin Hartley Charitable Foundation requires positive identification of all recipients.
The Hartley Charitable Foundation? Did he say the Hartley Charitable Foundation?
Daniel, what's going on? They're repossessing everything.
Betty, shh. Please, with everything falling apart around here, just let me have this moment. Every year, Cal Hartley hosts a charity Easter egg hunt at the Museum of Natural History.
Wait, Cal Hartley?
Oh, it's incredibly exclusive. I've been trying to score an invite for years.
Daniel, I think maybe this might be...
The Calvin Hartley Charitable Foundation is pleased to invite Betty Suarez?
Cal Hartley is Matt's father.
Of course, Matt Hartley. I don't know why I never put that together. So things are going really great with you and Matt, I guess.
Yeah.
Seeing as
Got the big egg white. Here you are.
Sorry, Daniel, I had no idea.
No, it's fine. I'm sure you're gonna have fun mingling with the billionaires and the princesses and the popes and the...
Oh, sorry, Daniel. 1 second. Hello?
Aunt Betty, don't ever break up with Matt.
Why do you need my fingerprints?
What are you talking about?
We just got an invitation to the Hartley Easter Egg Hunt. Do you know how exclusive this is?
I'm a U.S. citizen.
I have an idea.
I have rights, you know.
Grandpa, give him the thumbprint. You're not gonna mess this up for me. Go.
Look, Justin, I don't really have time for this right now, but I'll call you back, okay? Bye.
Everything okay?
Yeah, he was just really excited about going to the Hartley thing.
Your family got an invitation?
Magnificent mama.
Oh, thank you, Miles. Mm-hmm. Can we take a break, please?
Christina, come get him.
Oh. Come on, little man. Oh, my back is killing me.
Oh, you poor thing. You've been holding him for, what, a whole 5 minutes? Try doing it for 9 months.
Yes, 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 you're a saint. And his diaper's full as well. Miles, darling, thank you so much for capturing these precious moments.
Oh, it's my pleasure, Wilhelmina. That woman.
Oh, she's my surrogate. She's helped me out until I find a more suitable nanny arrangement.
Was she your egg donor as well?
What? No. Why would you suggest such a thing?
Well, the baby doesn't exactly look like you.
But Miles, his father is white. What do you expect? I mean, he'll brown up eventually.
No, it's not just that, Wilhelmina. My business is seeing, especially faces. And your child really looks like that woman.
Well, that's preposterous.
Be yes. What'd you do?
Listen, not to worry. I can work wonders with Photoshop. I'll give him the Slater chin. Mm.
From the summit of Mount Everest to the heights of Earth's orbit, whether he's brokering peace in the Middle East, inventing a new artificial hip, or winning his third Indianapolis 500, Cal Hartley personifies the pinnacle of human achievement. Billionaire, philanthropist, innovator, there is no part of your life that Cal Hartley hasn't touched and probably made better.
Yep, that's Dad.
Please adopt me.
Forget it.
Unless you take me too.
Man, we really appreciate you inviting us to your father's fundraiser, but I just feel we wouldn't fit in.
Don't even go there, Grandpa. I've been waiting for this my whole life.
Yeah, and I hear that they have a real Faberge egg hidden in with the Easter eggs. I'm so finding it.
Faberge.
No, sweetie, when there's an E at the end, it's silent.
Matt, are you sure you want to do this? I mean, I didn't exactly start off on the right foot with your mom, and I was hoping for less pressure with your dad. You know, maybe we could have him over for dinner, Bubby could cook, and we'll just talk about mountain climbing.
Well, you know, meeting my father is a really big deal. I mean, this guy turns down invitations to the White House.
Matt, you're not helping.
Look, the point is, 4 former presidents want to meet that guy, but... to me, that guy is Dad. Betty, I want you to meet my dad.
Okay, all right, we're in.
Yeah.
What? I figured the best way to make a good first impression on Mr. Hartley was to learn as much about him as I can. Did you know he went into outer space?
Oh, I wish I was that rich. I'd like to go into outer space.
Wow, there are like 1 million interviews with him. Here's one in the Dubai Financial Times. Hartley made his reputation writing to the rescue of struggling companies.
I'd like to rescue struggling companies.
Daniel, we are a struggling company.
Listen, among the assets Hartley considers undervalued and ripe for reinvestment are media companies, including newspaper and magazine publishing.
He said that?
Yeah. Daniel, what if we got Hartley to invest in Mead?
He could be our white knight.
He could save the company.
No, but Hartley is notoriously hard to get to. Do you really think you can set it up?
Are you kidding? Matt would be more than happy to set up a meeting with you and his father.
Betty, if you can pull this off...
I can do it.
I can't do it.
It's just a meeting.
No, I can't.
Daniel only wants a chance to talk to your dad.
Look, everybody wants to talk to my father. Invitations to the White House, remember? Everybody in the world always wants something from it.
No, but Matt, it's not like that. This is an opportunity for him.
Yeah, and it's always an opportunity. Betty, look, you have to trust me. It is not a good idea.
But Matt...
No. I'm sorry. The answer is no.
Do. Daniel really needs my help, but I don't want to do anything to upset Matt.
Ugh, poor Matt. You don't know how much pressure is on these rich people. It's incredible.
What do you know about rich people?
Excuse me. I've been watching Dynasty on the Soap Channel. They're not like us.
Listen, I don't know about Dynasty, but if the choice is between disappointing your boss or keeping your rich boyfriend happy, show me the money.
Oh, yeah. It's like when Blake has to choose between his wife, Crystal, and her look-alike Rita, also played by Linda Evans in a red wig. Catch up, people.
You know, mija, you tried to help out and it didn't work. Daniel will understand. Just tell him the truth.
You're probably right, Bobby. I should just tell him the truth.
Oh, look at little William here. This shot really brings out that Slater chin.
Oh, honestly, Willie, you haven't had a Slater chin since 1981.
Well, look at these cheekbones, see?
Well, as much as I live to tell you what you want to hear, I don't think babies have cheekbones.
Well, then he must take after Bradford, I suppose.
Actually, except for the fish belly complexion, I don't see Bradford in there either. What's this all about, Willie?
Oh, nothing, I guess. It's just... Well, Miles says the baby looks a lot like Christina.
Oh, my God, he does. Does he? Really? I don't see it.
Mark, this is my baby. I don't care what that overrated lens jockey Miles Foster says. I know my own child.
Of course you do. Why are we even discussing this? We were both there when they did the procedure. It was your egg mixed with Bradford's swim team.
The baby can't be Christina's. It's medically impossible.
Actually, it is medically possible.
You're joking.
If the surrogate had sexual intercourse before the implantation, it's possible she was already pregnant. In that case, your egg wouldn't have taken, and the baby would be her biological child.
Well, that's all very educational. Thank you for coming down, Doctor.
That's it?
Yes.
Because you said it was urgent. I rushed out of surgery to get it.
Thank you.
Mark, dear God, William might not be mine.
I'm so sorry.
Well, it's unacceptable. Without little William's share of the company, I go back to being a paid employee, with Daniel's girlish fingers at my throat. I need you to find out if Christina had sex right before the procedure, and do it discreetly.
Daniel, I need to talk to you.
And I want to talk to you, too. All right. Guys, thank you, everyone. Good work. I think it's time to go and get some rest.
Have you been here all night? Why didn't you call me?
Well, I know you're busy with Matt. We decided to go all in on your Hartley idea.
All in?
Yep. I called in marketing, ad sales, the art department. We put together such a kick-ass proposal for my meeting with Hartley.
Daniel, before you start kicking ass,
wait till you see what we came up with. We are gonna blow him away.
For over 100 years, Mead Publications has helped to educate, inform, and entertain generations of Americans. Now, leading this bold charge into the next millennium is a true visionary, businessman, humanitarian, and world-class athlete, Daniel Mead.
Athlete?
Yeah, I was on the crew team, JV. Besides, if Hartley's going to put money into Mead, the company's got to have confidence in Mead, the man. Did you notice I got the guy who did the voice for Hartley's to do mine?
Daniel,
I mean, it's still a work in progress. I'm going to Photoshop the margarita out of my hand, maybe put in, like, an orphan baby. But hey, I got to tell you, this is the first time in months I feel like we actually have a chance. So, what do you think?
He's gonna love it. You're gonna knock his socks off in that meeting.
You didn't really say knock his socks off, did you?
It just came out. What am I gonna do? Daniel thinks that this meeting with Hartley could help save the company. And I have to tell him it's not even gonna happen.
Well, the man is a true visionary, so he may already know.
Oh, there he is. There's a little product of an unholy deal with the devil. Yes, you are.
You're so good with him.
Who knew? I thought my only maternal instinct was nursing a bottle of whiskey.
Stuart's coming by in a little while and we're going to go for a walk in the park.
Oh, how is Stuart?
Better, actually.
At first we thought the treatment wasn't working, but it seems to be improving.
You should see him with his little ankle biter, all cooing and making faces.
So what are you going to do about Daniel?
I don't know. But I just have to make sure that he and Matt do not see each other until I figure it out. Oh, speak of the devil. Hello?
Hey, it's me.
Hi, I was just about to call you.
Okay, we're still talking, that's good. I just want to say I'm sorry I lost it about, you know, Daniel wanted to meet my dad and I was hoping I could take you out to lunch.
That sounds great. Where do you want to meet?
Actually, I'm heading towards your desk right now.
What? Don't go to my desk. I'm not at my desk. Let's play a game. You try to find me.
Ooh, sort of like a sexy scavenger hunt?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay, here I come.
Hey, I have a lunch uptown. I'll be back in a couple of hours.
Good. Have a good lunch.
Thanks.
Warmer.
Found you. Don't make me taser you.
I forgot my briefcase on your desk.
Oh, no. Go back to the elevator. I'll go get it.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll see you there. Have a good lunch.
Thanks.
Found you.
Yay, you found me. You win.
Betty, I totally forgot. Hey, Matt.
Hey, Daniel.
We should probably just get going.
Okay. Can't thank you enough for setting up this meeting with your father.
Daniel.
Excuse me?
I really think it'll be an incredible investment opportunity for him.
I didn't set any meeting.
What?
told Betty I couldn't do it.
Betty? What's going on?
Yeah, Betty. What is going on? Why'd you tell him I'd set up a meeting with Dad?
Well, I didn't, exactly.
Yes, you did.
Look, I can't explain this. Just not with both of you right here. Daniel, will you go wait for me in the conference room?
I have a lunch.
Please. I was gonna tell him this morning, but when I came in, he'd been up all night working on a proposal. I didn't want to break his heart.
Look, but he was gonna find out eventually.
Yes, but I was hoping that I could talk to you again. Remember when you said that I could ask you for anything? Submarine Thursdays?
Okay, Betty, that was different.
It's just a business meeting between the head of Mead Publications and a potential investor. It has nothing to do with us.
But it does. Betty, being Cal Hartley's son, it's like I'm two different people. Right there, there's the guy whose father is worth more than most OPEC countries, and then I'm the guy who writes about sports and forgets his wallet and gets a lump in his throat every time his girlfriend smiles at him. Betty, there's my dad and business and money, and then there's me, my life. You're part of my life, aren't you?
Yes, of course. Daniel.
Why didn't you just tell me he said no?
Because you were so excited. I didn't want to disappoint you.
So you let me look like an idiot?
I thought I could change his mind.
And?
Sorry. I don't know what else to do, Daniel. I know how important this is to the company, but Matt is my boyfriend. And if this is what he wants, then I have to respect that.
I understand.
You do?
I imagine Matt's gotta have his reasons. Family can be complicated. I ought to know. It's okay, Betty.
So what are we gonna do?
Well, I admit things don't look very good, but we're not ready to turn the lights out just yet. We'll figure something out. There are always other options.
There are no other options.
Well, I can't accept that.
Face the facts, Daniel. We barely cobbled together the cash to put the last issue on the newsstands. The government's not going to help us, and the banks won't touch us.
What you're talking about, we agreed we were not there yet.
Well, we're there now. The company has survived for over 100 years. People were reading Moe during the past two world wars. They were burning it for warmth during the Great Depression. I mean, I will be damned if I'm going to explain to my son, your half-brother, that we stood by and let it die.
I certainly don't want that either, but what do we...
We have poured every penny into keeping this magazine afloat. Money of our own. If we let it go under, we have nothing. Time to make some tough choices.
You're right. I'll take care of it.
I've been thinking, we don't really talk very much.
That's because we don't like each other very much.
And it tears me up inside. We've been spending so much time together because of the baby. We should be pals.
I'm good, actually.
You know, it's a fun thing for us girls to do? A sex quiz.
I am in. My sex IQ is crazy high. I'm like the Einstein of sex.
Okay. What is your favorite season to have sex?
Fall! No, spring! Winter! No, summer! Oh, this is gonna be harder than I thought.
I heard summer. Good answer. Like June? Don't you love having sex in June?
June 14th at 3:02 p.m. I was in the ladies' room at the UN. Janos, he's the delegate from Hungary. And he was. I have a pornographic memory.
Okay, back to Christina. Sizzling summer sexcapades, go!
Why are you so interested in my sex life?
What? It's just a quiz.
I started to think about it and then I realized June. That was when I had Wilhelmina's egg implanted, and the only reason that he would want to know if I'd had sex...
He's a pervert.
No, listen. Do you remember a couple of days before the procedure, we went out to dinner to that little pub on the Lower East Side?
Yeah, yeah, you were pretty upset about the whole thing. You must have had, what, 5 or 6 pints? Couldn't keep your hands off me?
Shut up! Just listen. They told me I wasn't supposed to have sex before the procedure, but I thought it was just the one time and the chance of anything happening...
Christina, could he be our son? What are we going to do?
Well, I've got to talk to Wilhelmina and we've got to find out the truth.
I hate myself for watching, but I can't look away.
Oh, not Sven, not Sven.
Hello.
Well, I guess that'll save some awkward conversation by the coffee machine.
This is crazy.
Oh my God.
Sorry, Amanda.
Amanda? I'm fired. This must be some sort of mistake.
I know, right? I mean, I understand them getting rid of the lunch intern and the creepy copy guy and all those editors, but I'm Amanda Tannen Summers.
Oh, Mandy, I'm so sorry.
I am the face of Mode. I am Mode. I'm the first person they see when they walk in. Who's going to welcome them now and tell them where to sign in? But they need to see something pretty.
It's gonna be okay, sweetie. This isn't the end of the world. Someone's gonna hire you in a second.
Really? Because I can do a job that a clipboard and a vase of flowers can do.
Oh, Mandy.
Mark, I don't belong anywhere else. I belong at Mode. This is my home. What am I gonna do? Oh.
Daniel. Amanda was just fired. What's going on?
Look, before you panic, your job is safe. You're too valuable to let go.
Well, thanks, but what about everyone else? I thought you said there were options.
Well, unfortunately, it turned out there really was only one option.
Fire everybody?
Do you think I like firing people? I like Amanda. I like Jenny in accounting. It was either cut the payroll or file for bankruptcy. Then none of us would have jobs. Is that what you want?
No. No, of course not.
Betty, we shut down 5 magazines today. That's hundreds of employees. I didn't have a choice. I'm sorry.
I'm getting you that meeting with Hartley. Come on.
I don't have an invitation.
Daniel, it's now or never. He's leaving for a Trans-Siberian motorcycle race right after the party.
Yeah, but what about Matt? How's he gonna feel about you going behind his back?
I hope he understands.
Thank you.
Faberge come to Mama? Ugh. Damn. Here. Hey.
Hey.
Matt,
you're
I have
really
something.
Pretty. So, ready for the moment of truth?
Yep.
Hey guys, you want to come over and meet my dad? It was right here. Yeah. All right. Here we go. Dad, I would like you to meet the Suarez family. Justin, Hilda, Ignacio, my father.
It is a pleasure,
Mr. Hartley, sir.
No, please call me Cal. Justin, Hilda, are we treating you okay?
Oh yeah. Hey, listen, you want to give me a hint on where the Faberge egg is?
Mom?
I don't think that would be fair to my other guests. And this must be the young lady that I've been waiting to meet.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Mr. Hartley.
I heard you made quite an impression on Matt's mother. I think the words she used were, over my dead, rotting corpse.
Dad.
Well, the thing is, I don't really...
Anyone who can get under my ex-wife's skin like that is okay in my book. Now, I would love to spend the whole afternoon just with you, but I have to spend some time with my other guests, so please, everybody, have a good time, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.
Sorry.
Wow, never shook a hand that's been in outer space before.
See? Piece of cake.
Oh. Work stuff that I just have to deal with real quick, but I'll be back.
Okay.
Where have you been? There's security everywhere. People are starting to look at me weird.
Because you're supposed to be a waiter, but you're standing around eating cookies in a $10,000 Prada suit.
This is from 2 years ago.
All right, look, I met Mr. Hartley.
What's he like?
He's interesting, but nice, and I think he'll be open to your thoughts. You ready?
I think so.
Okay, maybe leave the cookie. You had sex?
Do I need to remind you that we had a signed contract?
What, you're going to sue me for having sex?
I gave you a great deal of money. Money that was supposed to help save your dying husband. At least part of him was alive and kicking.
Oh, don't get all high and mighty with me. You rammed that contract right down my throat.
And you knew exactly what you were getting yourself into.
And you knew that I couldn't say no. Because the contract was barely dry before I was lying on my back with my legs in the air, someone waving a turkey baster at me.
Mm. Lovely.
I want to know what we're going to do now. Because there is a chance that that baby is mine.
An infinitesimal chance.
It's still a chance. I need to know whose baby that is. And so do you.
Yes, I do. We'll get a blood test. Then we'll know.
Right.
There he is. Let's go.
Excuse me, sir. May I see your credentials?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Hey. Second. I had him a second ago.
You know what? He's with me, so it's okay.
He needs his own invitation, ma'am.
This is outrageous. I want both your names right now. Do you have a pen?
Oh, okay. Mistake. Sorry. Ow,
ow. Please, just let him go. Okay. I can explain.
Ow, ow, ow. Come on. Listen. Listen, he can clear this up. Ow, ow, ow.
I know you're mad.
You lied to me.
Matt, Amanda got fired today, along with about half of Mead. And I couldn't just come here and drink champagne and hunt for Easter eggs and pretend like nothing was happening. What was I supposed to do?
You could have come to me.
Would you have changed your mind?
Is this really what you want?
Matt, you mean so much to me.
But if giving Daniel 5 minutes with your dad is going to help him save me, then yes, it's what I want.
Hey, 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 it's okay. He's with me. Dad, I'd like to introduce you to Betty's boss, Daniel Meade.
It's an incredible honor, sir.
Meade, huh? Don't recall seeing your name on the guest list?
It's a funny story, actually.
Come on, I'm just messing with you. Let's have a drink.
Great, great, great.
Matt, thank you.
I know you've shown an interest in media stocks. Of course, I read your amazing interview in the Dubai Financial Times. Anyway, Meade Publications is poised to rebound in a big way. Mr. Hartley?
Cal.
Cal. Everything all right?
I raise a lot of money at this shindig every year for a lot of terrific causes. But what I love about it most is the kids, you know?
Absolutely.
Simple joy in a child's face, that's what it's really about.
I couldn't agree with you more. Anyway, all Meade needs is a short-term infusion of operating...
It's such a shame Floppy couldn't make it.
Floppy.
Yeah, Floppy the bunny. He's the guy we hired to put on the big pink bunny suit and hand out eggs. Just totally flaked on us.
That is a shame. As I was saying, a short-term infusion with capital
would
really...
We got the suit and everything. We just need someone to put it on. Hop around. Wiggle his nose. That'd sure make this day a success, don't you think? Make those kids smile. And seeing those kids' smiling faces would sure put me in the mood to talk business.
I got it! I got the egg!
Congratulations. Now, why don't you step up here, young lady?
Okay.
Oh, excuse me, kids.
Oh,
here we go. Now, since you found the Fabergé egg valued at more than $500,000, it will now be auctioned off and the proceeds donated to New York Children's Hospital in your name.
But I found it. I found the egg, sir. All right. This isn't fair.
Time to go. Isn't she wonderful?
Finished. Do you hate me, Matt? Because I hate me right now.
No, 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 I can never hate you. Never. And you were right. People's jobs are at stake. I mean, your friends are getting fired because I have some crazy rich boy daddy issues. That's messed up.
No, Matt, I still should not have gone behind your back.
True. You owe me for that one. I may have to cancel Submarine Thursdays. Betty, I just... hope you don't regret hooking Daniel up with my father.
Why would I?
My dad can be a great guy, but you do not want to go into business with him. He needs to control everything. But I've spent my entire life trying to keep him as far away from my career as possible. That's why I didn't want him investing in Meade, working in publishing. And I finally found something that was mine.
But Matt, you don't even work at Meade.
But you do. Betty, you don't know where this could lead.
Come on, it can't be that bad.
It's Floppy!
Daniel?
I want an egg!
You thought my mom was a tough one? My mom's like an Easter egg. Hard on the outside, but soft and gooey on the inside. Dad's more like Satan.
Idea this would happen.
It's okay.
No, it's not okay. Matt tried to warn me and I wouldn't listen, and his father humiliated you.
Betty.
I did it.
What?
I just spent 10 minutes with Hartley running the numbers. He's in.
It's actually delaying his trip to Siberia so we can make a full proposal. He said he looks forward to being in the publishing business.
Oh my God! That's amazing! What? But what about all of this?
Just to prove what a big man he is.
So you knew what he was doing?
Of course I did. I've been dealing with ego-driven bastards like him my whole life. You know, I made a fool of myself enough times for no reason. I can do it once to save our company.
Daniel. I'm so proud of you. What's that?
It's just my cottontail. I was using it to stop the bleeding.
Ooh. Those kids were vicious, huh?
Here they are, the lab results.
You haven't opened it?
Yeah, I have. I didn't have the nerve. You open it. It's yours. The baby's yours. Thank God.
I was so sure.
Well, now that that is settled, I will be making other arrangements for William's care.
What do you mean?
I will no longer be needing your services as a nanny. Given the circumstances, I think it's best that you stay away from my child. Permanently.
I read your amazing interview in the Dubai Financial Times. Anyway, Mead Publications is poised to rebound in a big way. Mr. Hartley?
Cal.
Everything all right?
I raise a lot of money at this shindig every year for a lot of terrific causes. But what I love about it most is the kids, you know?
Absolutely.
Simple joy in a child's face, that's what it's really about.
I couldn't agree with you more. Anyway, all Mead needs is a short-term infusion of operating...
It's such a shame Floppy couldn't make it.
Floppy?
Yeah, Floppy the bunny. He's the guy we hired to put on the big pink bunny suit and hand out eggs. Just totally flaked on us.
That is a shame. As I was saying, a short-term infusion would capital...
We got
really...
the suit and everything. We just need someone to put it on. Hop around. Wiggle his nose. That sure make this day a success, don't you think? Make those kids smile.
Mark, dear God, William might not be mine.
I'm so sorry.
Well, it's unacceptable. Without little William's share of the company, I go back to being a paid employee, with Daniel's girlish fingers at my throat. I need you to find out if Christina had sex right before the procedure, and do it discreetly.
I need to talk to you.
And I want to talk to you, too. All right. Guys, thank you, everyone. Good work. I think it's time to go and get some rest.
Have you been here all night? Why didn't you call me?
Well, I know you're busy with Matt. We decided to go all in on your Hartley idea.
All in?
Yep. I called in marketing, ad sales, the art department. We put together such a kick-ass proposal for my meeting with Hartley.
Daniel, before you start kicking ass,
wait till you see what we came up with. We are going to blow him away.
For over 100 years, Mead Publications has helped to educate, inform, and entertain generations of Americans. Now, leading this bold charge into the next millennium is a true visionary, businessman, humanitarian.
You're right. I'll take care of it.
I've been thinking, we don't really talk very much.
That's because we don't like each other very much.
And it tears me up inside. We've been spending so much time together because of the baby. We should be pals.
I'm good, actually.
You know, it's a fun thing for us girls to do? A sex quiz.
I am in. My sex IQ is crazy high. I'm like the Einstein of sex.
Okay. What is your favorite season to have sex?
Fall! No, spring! Winter! No, summer.
Oh, this is gonna be harder than I thought.
I heard summer. Good answer! Like, June? Don't you love having sex in June?
June 14th at 3:02 p.m. I was in the ladies' room at the UN. Janos, he's the delegate from Hungary. And he was. I have a pornographic memory.
Okay, back to Christina. Sizzling summer sexcapades, go!
Why are you so interested in my sex life?
What? It's just a quiz.
Seeing those kids' smiling faces would sure put me in the mood to talk business.
Congratulations. Now, why don't you step up here, young lady?
Okay.
Oh, excuse me, kids.
Excuse me.
Oh, here we go. Now, since you found the Fabergé egg valued at more than $500,000, it will now be auctioned off and the proceeds donated to New York Children's Hospital in your name.
But I found it. I found the egg, sir. All right. This isn't fair.
Time to go. Isn't she wonderful?
Oh,
Are we finished? Do you hate me, Matt? Because I hate me right now.
No, 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 I could never hate you. Never. And you were right. People's jobs are at stake. I mean, your friends are getting fired because I have some crazy rich boy daddy issues. That's messed up.
No, Matt, I still should not have...
Someone to put it on. Hop around. Wiggle his nose.
That sure make this day a success, don't you think? Make those kids smile.
And seeing those kids' smiling faces would sure put me in the mood to talk business.
Congratulations. Now, why don't you step up here, young lady?
Okay.
Oh, excuse me, kids.
Excuse me.
Oh, here we go. Now, since you found the Fabergé egg valued at more than $500,000, it will now be auctioned off and the proceeds donated to New York Children's Hospital in your name.
But I found it. I found the egg, sir.
All right.
This isn't fair.
Time to go. Isn't she wonderful?
Are we finished? Do you hate me, Matt? Because I hate me right now.
No. No, no.
Brings out that Slater chin.
Oh, honestly, Willie, you haven't had a Slater chin since 1981.
Well, look at these cheekbones, see?
Well, as much as I live to tell you what you want to hear, I don't think babies have cheekbones.
Well, then he must take after Bradford, I suppose.
Actually, except for the fish belly complexion, I don't see Bradford in there either. What's this all about, Willie?
Oh, nothing, I guess. It's just... Well, Miles says the baby looks a lot like Christina.
Oh, my God, he does. I mean, does he? Really? I don't see it.
Mark, this is my baby. I don't care what that overrated lens jockey Miles Foster says. I know my own child.
Of course you do. Why are we even discussing this? We were both there when they did the procedure. It was your egg mixed with Bradford's... Zoom team. The baby can't be Christina's. It's medically impossible.
Actually, it is medically possible.
You're joking.
If the surrogate had sexual intercourse before the implantation, it's possible she was already pregnant. In that case, your egg wouldn't have taken, and the baby would be her biological child.
Well, that's all very educational. Thank you for coming down, Doctor.
That's it?
Yes.
Because you said it was urgent.
I got it! I got the egg!
Congratulations. Now, why don't you step up here, young lady?
Okay.
Oh, excuse me, kids.
Excuse me.
Oh, here we go. Now, since you found the Fabergé egg valued at more than $500,000... It will now be auctioned off and the proceeds donated to New York Children's Hospital in your name.
But I found it. I found the egg, sir.
All right.
This isn't fair.
Time to go. Isn't she wonderful?
Are we finished? Do you hate me, Matt? Because I hate me right now.
No, 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 I could never hate you. Never. And you were right. People's jobs are at stake. I mean, your friends are getting fired because I have some crazy rich boy daddy issues. That's messed up.
No, Matt, I still should not have gone behind your back.
True. You owe me for that one. I may have to cancel Submarine Thursdays. Betty, I just... hope you don't regret hooking Daniel.
It's okay. He's with me.
Dad, I'd like to introduce you to Betty's boss, Daniel Meade.
It's an incredible honor, sir.
Meade, huh? Don't recall seeing your name on the guest list?
It's a funny story. Actually,
come on, I'm just messing with you. Let's have a drink.
Great, great, great.
Matt, thank you.
I know you've shown an interest in media stocks. Of course, I read your amazing interview in the Dubai Financial Times. Anyway, Meade Publications is poised to rebound in a big way. Mr. Hartley?
Cal.
Cal. Everything all right?
I raise a lot of money at this shindig every year for a lot of terrific causes. But what I love about it most is the kids, you know?
Take a break, please. Christina, come get him.
Oh, come on, little man.
Oh, my back is killing me.
Oh, you poor thing. You've been holding him for, what, a whole 5 minutes? Try doing it for 9 months.
Yes, 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 you're a saint. And his diaper's full as well. Miles, darling, thank you so much for capturing these precious moments.
Oh, it's my pleasure, Wilhelmina. That woman.
Oh, she's my surrogate. She's helped me out until I find a more suitable nanny arrangement.
Was she your egg donor as well?
What? No. Why would you suggest such a thing?
Well, the baby doesn't exactly look like you.
Well, Miles, his father is white. What do you expect? I mean, he'll brown up eventually.
No, it's not just that, Wilhelmina. My business is seeing, especially faces. And your child really looks like that woman.
Well, that's preposterous.
Yes. What'd you do?
Listen, not to worry. I can work wonders with Photoshop. I'll give him the Slater chin. Mm.
From the summit of Mount Everest to the heights of Earth's orbit, whether he's brokering peace in...
Daniel, I'm so sorry. I had no idea this would happen.
It's okay.
No, it's not okay. Matt tried to warn me, and I wouldn't listen, and his father humiliated you.
Betty.
I did it.
What?
I just spent 10 minutes with Hartley running the numbers. He's in.
It's actually delaying his trip to Siberia so we can make a full proposal. He said he looks forward to being in the publishing business.
What? But what about all of this?
Just to prove what a big man he is.
So you knew what he was doing?
Of course I did. I've been dealing with ego-driven bastards like him my whole life. You know, I made a fool of myself enough times for no reason. I can do it once to save our company.
Daniel, I'm so proud of you. What's that?
It's just my cottontail. I was using it to stop the bleeding.
Ooh.
Thank you.
Mark, dear God, William might not be mine.
I'm so sorry.
Well, it's unacceptable. Without little William's share of the company, I go back to being a paid employee. With Daniel's girlish fingers at my throat. I need you to find out if Christina had sex right before the procedure. And do it discreetly.
I need to talk to you.
And I want to talk to you, too. All right. Guys, thank you, everyone. Good work. I think it's time to go and get some rest.
Have you been here all night? Why didn't you call me?
Well, I know you're busy with Matt. We decided to go all in on your Hartley idea.
All in?
Yep. I called in marketing, ad sales, the art department. We put together such a kick-ass proposal for my meeting with Hartley.
Daniel, before you start kicking ass,
wait till you see what we came up with. We are gonna blow him away.
For over 100 years, Mead Publications has helped to educate, inform, and entertain generations of Americans. Now, leading this bold charge into the next millennium is a true visionary business.
Hey, I've been thinking, we don't really talk very much.
That's because we don't like each other very much.
And it tears me up inside. We've been spending so much time together because of the baby. We should be pals.
I'm good, actually.
You know, it's a fun thing for us girls to do? A sex quiz.
I am in. My sex IQ is crazy high. I'm like the Einstein of sex.
Okay. What is your favorite season to have sex?
Fall. No, spring. Winter. No, summer.
Oh, this is going to be harder than I thought.
I heard summer. Good answer. Like June? Don't you love having sex in June?
June 14th at 3:02 p.m. I was in the ladies' room at the UN. Janos, he's the delegate from Hungary. And he was. I have a pornographic memory.
Okay, back to Christina. Sizzling summer sexcapades, go!
Why are you so interested in my sex life?
What? It's just a quiz.
I started to think about it and then I realized June. That was when I had Wilhelmina's egg implanted, and the only reason that he would want to know if I'd had sex